Hello, my dear friends! This is my review for the movie Batman vs. Superman Dawn of Justice from the side of the audience. Let's start with the things that we didn't like in the movie. Jesse Eisenberg, who was very good at The Social Network and Now You See Me movies, he didn't change his acting for the character of Lex Luthor. Also in this movie was a smart-ass guy that he talks too much. If Zack Snyder let him free to create the character of Luthor, then he was completely wrong. Lex Luthor is not a smartass, he's a fucking psychotic genius, not a mix of Riddler and Joker. Also, we don't agree with his choice in casting because he is too young for this role. Jeremy Irons is a wonderful actor, but he is too young for the role of Alfred. You have to be a sir for this role. That was the only negative of his part in the film. Otherwise, he was very good. Doomsday, the villain of the movie, was like Troll in Lord of the Rings. I thought for a while that Gandalf will pop out and tell him,
"You shall not pass!"
Another negative point in the movie was that Gotham and Metropolis was too near, just like Manhattan and New Jersey. As we know all these years, Batman is protecting only Gotham. We never heard him say,
"Alfred, there is a problem in Metropolis. I have to go there."
Last but not least, we believe that the title of the movie should be Man of Steel, Dawn of Justice, because the director gives more importance to Superman than the other characters. Let's see what we liked in this movie. The special effects were very good, as it is in every superhero movie. We are not going to deal with technical specifications, because we told you at the start of this video that this review is from the side of the audience. Henry Cavill is very good as Superman, as he was in his first movie Man of Steel. After Christopher Reeve, he is a worthy replacement. Okay, now it's the time of Ben Affleck. Unfortunately for the critics, we liked him as Batman. Ben, you don't have to be sad anymore. People have the power, not the critics. The only negative with his role and the Batman character is that his act overshadowed by the act of Christian Bale, who was in my opinion exceptional. The blame is on Hollywood, which doesn't protect the actors. It's only 4 years since the last movie of Christopher Nolan's Batman. The same happened with Spider-Man. Hollywood, shame on you! Concerning all that has written about the brutality of Batman in this movie, please consider that Batman in his first comics back at 1940s was vengeful, not hesitant to kill when he saw it was necessary. Gal Gadot, the Wonder Woman. If you like her a lot at Fast and Furious, then you're gonna love her in this movie. She is hot, hot, hot! We also like the participation of Patrick Tatopoulos in production design. Why? Because he's Greek! In every blockbuster there's a Greek participation, and we are proud of it. Why you don't have to be so negative in the idea that Batman is against Superman? This was not the idea of Zack Snyder. The film was influenced by Frank Miller's The Dark Knight Returns and comic book The Death of Superman. Finally, I want to give you an advice. Women don't like this kind of movies. If you want to make her build a time in your hug, go watch a thriller. That's all, folks. I hope I helped you. If you like this video, don't forget to share and subscribe. See ya!